Aladdin Creations.
Hello friends, welcome to Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. So this is the part 2 video of our malaria video series. In my previous videos, I have discussed with you topic number 1, what is malaria. So in this video, I am going to discuss with you topic number 2, life cycle of malaria parasites. Let's talk about the life cycle of malaria parasite. Now we know that malaria is a mosquito-borne disease and caused by protozoan parasite of Plasmodium species, particularly Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium malariae, and Plasmodium ovale. To complete the life cycle of Plasmodium species require two phases, including asexual and sexual. When we talk about human malaria, the asexual stages occur in human, while sexual stages occur in Anopheles mosquito. Again, these asexual phases can be divided into two stages, exoerythrocytic stage or hepatic stage and erythrocytic stage. Therefore, in human, the parasite grow and multiply first in liver and then attack the red blood cells. These plastic stages of parasite are responsible for the symptoms of malaria. Infected Anopheles mosquito contain sporocytes, a form of parasites, in their salivary gland. When they bite a human, they inject saliva together with sporocytes, which first migrate to the liver and start hepatic phase of the zygogony. Sporocytes infect the hepatocyte and mature into zygote. Then it will rupture and release merocytes. Here, there is special cases in Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale. Some of zygote can become a dormant stage called hypnocytes and persist in liver. Later they become activated and cause relapses by invading bloodstream. After this liver zygogony, the merocytes infect red blood cells and begin erythrocytic cycle. Merocytes become ring-shaped trophocytes and then mature into zygote within red blood cells. Mature zygote then rupture and release merocytes into bloodstream. This merocyte can attack again uninfected and infected red blood cells and occur in cyclic manner. Some of these stages differentiate into male and female gametocytes, also be called as microgametocytes and macrogametocytes. When an Anopheles mosquito obtains a blood meal, it ingests these gametocytes as well. In the stomach of the mosquito, microgametocytes become microgamete and macrogametocytes become macrogamete. One of these microgamete penetrate the macrogamete and generate zygote. The zygote become motile and elongated, giving rise to oocinate, which invade the midgut wall. Oocinate in midgut wall develop into oocyst. Oocysts develop and release sporocytes, which find their places in salivary gland of mosquito. When mosquito take a blood meal from human, it include sporocyte into the blood and this initiate a new cycle. As a summary, malaria life cycle, asexual life stage occur in human. Sexual life stage occur in Anopheles mosquito. Malaria infective stage is sporocytes. Diagnostic stages are immature trophocyte or in stage, mature trophocyte, zygote and gametocyte. Hypnocytes or dormant stage only occurs in Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale. Symptoms of malaria are caused by ruptured merocytes in blood. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoy this video and gain knowledge about this malaria parasite life cycle. So don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.